Hey guys, Dude Longcouch here. How are you all doing? Welcome back to Resident Evil 7. Okay guys, so I swapped out the Magnum for the Burner because I don't have a ton of ammo for my Magnum and I want to start hoarding whatever ammo I can find for it. And I figure the Burner will probably be pretty good against these new and improved molded that we've had to fight lately. And I also grabbed my last regular chem fluid so I could make one more health pack with it, which we will do right now. And now I have two of those and one herb in reserve. I've got my defense coin still, I've got the model shotgun, because I think I'm going to want to try and swap that out really quick. And I still got the toy axe. Now, I don't know for sure what we're going to do with that, but I have an idea based on the comments from you guys. So we're going to try all that out in this video and try and make some progress here. Now, last time, I'm pretty sure I got attacked right out here. So I'm going to see if I can wipe out whatever these fuckers are that are out here. Because I want this house to be a safe place. I don't want to be dicking around. Of course, now they're not here. So... Oh! Hello! I think I found a dude just chilling out here, just contemplating like— Oh! He's fucking clever! He waited till I wasn't looking! Okay, that didn't stop him at all. That's fantastic. I should not have come this way. I shouldn't have come this way! Give me a fucking break, man! Oh, I don't like this at all. I don't like this. They do so much damage now. I wonder what it would be like if I didn't have that damn defense coin. Can you get staggered, like, even once, please? Or just die, that's fine too. You piece of shit. God, they're so tough now, guys. It's not even fair. Okay, was that the dude who got me before? I guess it was. We're gonna have to keep an eye out, though, because... We don't know where the hell anybody could be now. Actually, while I'm down here... Just remembered, I wanted to come check out the garage again. I hope there's nothing waiting for us in here. But we could have... The, secret... Hidden item thing from the last photo that we found in here. I'm not 100% sure where it is. If it's not in here, then I do have another idea for that. But also, we haven't been in here for a while, so I kind of just want to look around. I don't see anything that resembles that photo. We'll go up top, too, because there's some stuff up there. Nope, I didn't mean to do that. Not quite finished down here. I probably should use, like, a psycho stim in here, because there were a lot of items. I think I did a pretty good job of clearing them out, though. Alright. Let's pop up here now and look. I'm sad I had to use that healing item already. I should probably use that herb, too. Alright, what? Oh! Oh, there's a shotgun shell up here! I totally missed that before. But not the hidden item. Well, that was worth the trip anyway. Just for that one shotgun shell. Let me use that. I still have a little bit of red. That pisses me off. Whatever. Did I just take fall damage? Did I just take fall damage? I'm not even sure. There's blood on the right side of my screen now. I think that might be new damage. Ugh, this game, guys. Alright, well, I don't like this area. I have a lot of bad, traumatic memories from here, so let's just move on, shall we? Let's get jumped by all the damn molded waiting for us in here now. I guess we're actually good for now. Alright, let's test this out. I'm not sure if this is gonna work, but I think it will. So we take that, the door closes, and now we replace it with the model shotgun. That totally works. Awesome! So now we have the broken shotgun, and you guys have told me that there's a repair kit in the crow door back yonder. And I didn't see one when I was in there. It could just be hidden really well. Or that could also be the spot for the last secret item photo that we found, because... that's happened before, where, like, I was told that an item was in a place, but I couldn't actually find it yet till I found that secret photo, and, I just didn't know it. So let's actually pop back here and take a look. Hold on. I just gotta clear this. Okay, yeah, I think we're good. So, in here... there are, like, shelving units in here. Is there a head and a ladder? No, I don't see anything like that. Sometimes they like to hide stuff really, really well. Just down behind other shit. That's one thing that's really, really cool about this game, guys. I wasn't sure about the whole psychostimulant mechanic when I first started playing. Because, like, it seemed like, well, if you just take your time and look really, really well, like, you shouldn't miss anything anyway. But the game really does a really great job of hiding stuff that's, like, it's always there, but it's, like, really easy to miss stuff, even if you're trying to be thorough. It blows my mind how well they integrated that. I don't know, guys. I don't see a repair kit in here. That's actually unfortunate, because I'd really like to have an improved shotgun. I would love that more than anything. And I don't actually know where that secret photo is now. There's a lot of places it could be. But, yeah. Just gonna peek back through here. Haven't been back to this area for a little while, so... Okay, yep. Not really seeing anything. Guess not. Guess that was a big W-O-T. It's a waste of time, guys. Well, anyways, so now what we want to do is find a clock. There's a grandfather clock. There it is. The puzzle said same time as all the other clocks. 10:15. 10:15 is the time we want. So let's get back up here. No molded. Really, really like that. Granny's still in here. Still looking at me. I don't like the way she looks at me. Stupid. Final boss, bitch. I know your plan. You're not slick. Okay, so we wind the clock. Let's go backwards, because that's smart. Okay. Yep, nailed it. Huh. Granny didn't, like, get up or anything, did she? Alright, now we're good. Oh, hey, no, no, no! Oh, you assholes. Oh, I didn't know that was gonna happen. Well, now we are what they call pot committed. My throat is really dry right now. I'm not sure if that's because I just woke up or because I'm scared. Could be a little bit of column A, a little bit of column B. Wow, this went down further than I thought it would, and it's really dark down here. Oh, come on.
Oh my god.
That's like the same kind of thing that we saw in the beginning of the game that we had to climb under to get through the path. It's like a... almost like a tableau that they're building. I wonder what that's for. Alright, let's clear the area before we go crazy with item collecting. Doesn't seem to be any enemies, we haven't triggered anything. My confidence in this burner has waned a little bit. Okay, there's the red key card. Because it just... I don't know, at least when fighting the molded. Oh, 10 enhanced handgun ammo. Fuck yes. So, okay. Now that... There we go. I can use it with this pistol. I guess the problem before, when I tested that, like, 4 videos ago or whatever, was that the enhanced handgun ammo I had then was already, like, tied to the original pistol. And even though I had unloaded it from it, I couldn't transfer it over to the new one. But now I know I can use enhanced handgun ammo with this pistol. And that should be, like, real good. That should be some good shit right there. Alright, I don't see anything else in here. Let's grab this key card. I always try to save the main item in a room for last. Red key card acquired. Fantastic. So we have to go this way. I would love to just go back out through that way, but we can't. I don't know where this is going to take us. You unlocked it. Oh, is this... This is the workshop. We finally got through the workshop. Okay. Good. So whatever item I was seeing with the Psycho Sims before, I have it now. I'm glad to know that. But they're gonna make me fight these fuckers down here again. What's the fastest way out of here? Is it back through there? I think it is. I'm gonna get jumped. I'm running. I'm not wasting ammo on this shit. Okay. Just keep going. He's dumb. There's another one! Shut the door! Did he get through? I made it, guys! Fuck you, molded! Look, he's trying to get through. You can see him trying to creep through the door. I don't give a shit. I'm out of here. If you spawn some up here, I'm eternally upset. No, I think we're good. Oh, phone call. Okay. Well, I guess we're relatively safe then.
Hey, buddy. Remember, those two key cards will get you into the party. Don't be late now.
Let me talk to Mia.
No. You gotta show up first. You haven't forgotten where the party is, have you? You can get in from the courtyard. So come on, man. Everybody's waiting for you.
I'm gonna have so much fun shooting a hole directly in your fucking redneck face. Okay, let's take stock here. I don't think we ever actually have to go back downstairs again, because I think at this point, we have hit every single area down there. Okay, that's the yard. That's showing us the locked doors that we now have the key cards for. We've got one more locked box up in the greenhouse area, which I have a lockpick for. We've actually been pretty much everywhere that we have access to, like, on the map now, guys. We've done a pretty good job of clearing out everything. I don't think there's anything left in here that we care about, so let's head back outside. Now, I don't know where that last repair kit is, but you guys have told me that there's something over here. Ah! Whoa! No! They put people out here! No! This has been a safe zone up till now. Die, please die. I need you to die. I need that more than anything. Fuck you. Get off me. Oh, I was not ready for that. Are you dead? Please. You're not dead! Fuck! Oh, he played possum. I thought he was dead. Jesus. I was even blocking from that. Dude! Fuck off! No. Four-legged molded. This type has little health, but walks on all fours and is very fast and nimble. Make sure to get your shots in whenever they stop long enough for you to- Little health? Suck my dick, little health! Alright guys, they spawned me back down in the red keycard room, and then they made me run through the molded area again and listen to the phone call again, so I'm gonna make a mad dash for this fucking safe room over here. If I just- Okay, he missed. Good. There's another one! God damn it, there's multiple ones! Fuck, let me in here. Fuck. I'm so upset right now. Okay, at least I'm here. I can save. I can do other things. We actually should watch that happy birthday tape. Because it's a tape, and we haven't done that yet. Why did... Hold on. Seven out of three. So if I put the regular ammo in there, and then look at the overspill... Yeah, it really does, like, lock the ammo into the gun that you're using. That's so weird. I mean, it's kind of nice that it doesn't take up more inventory space, I guess, but... That means I should use up... You know what? I should do that. I should store that, and I should get my original handgun back, and I should just use up that ammo. And then make sure I don't reload. Use that to take these dudes out. But before that, I'm gonna try and avoid as much bullshit as possible. Okay, so now if this goes horribly wrong, it doesn't actually matter all that much. Because I can just reload and try again, without any hassle. Alright, where are you fucks? clearing y'all out. I'm making this place safe. That is, if you're man enough to come fight me again. With your small amount of health. Fucking bullshit. Okay, well now they're not gonna be here. Cause, oh shit, there it is! Oh, I didn't even see him! They blend in really, really well, it turns out. Alright, come on. Okay, oh, his buddy showed up! God damn it, I don't know if I can handle both of them at the same time. I talked a big game, but they're fast. And they're relentless. And this gun doesn't have, like, a ton of stopping power. Okay, I think I got one of them. I think that's one. Okay. Gotta swap ammo. It just reloaded all... It put everything into this one. Son of a bitch. And by everything, I mean like the two that it already had and the three that were just chilling in my inventory. So that ruined this plan. That would have worked out perfect if they hadn't fucking done that. I'm so upset. How do I take this ammo out? I don't fucking want it anymore. Son of a bitch. I'm upset, guys. I'm upset. That's some tomfoolery right there. That's the only word I have for that. Is tomfoolery. I guess we'll take this back anyway. We'll have to remember that there's three handgun, enhanced handgun. There's three enhanced handgun rounds in that gun. If I actually need to go back to it for whatever reason. Alright, so over here, there's something back here. Oh, here it is. Oh, it's another shadow puzzle. Interesting. Won't open. Yeah, we gotta use something here. You guys have led me to believe that it is this toy axe. Looks like a... Okay, I was like, is it not working? What's going on? So I guess we just use this to kind of simulate a number, and then that's like the code to the chest or something. Except this isn't really working all that well. Is it too big right now? You gotta get an angle just right. It should be a 7, right? I don't think we can make like anything else with this. Oh, there's kind of a white outline there. Oh, I didn't even see that at first. So yeah, we gotta... This is actually really, really weird to manipulate. How the fuck did I get to this point? I'm trying to make it smaller. Okay, something like that. And then rotate that way. Guys, I swear I'm not just being, like, overly retarded right now. This is legit difficult. There we go. Alright, so that worked. And we get a stabilizer. Okay, I was kind of hoping for a repair kit. But a stabilizer's good, too. So, that is the thing. Relaxes the muscles and reduces stress, making reloading faster, effect lasts indefinitely. Well, pump that shit in. Give me my stuff, guys. Oh, yeah. Oh, that's good stuff. Oh, it feels so good. Alright, so we reload faster now. That's awesome. And we actually have a couple things that we need to take care of before we head into Lucas's area there. The first being, I need to get back up here and use this lockpick on this box up here. It's probably just a little bit of ammo or a health pack or something, but damned if I'm leaving it behind. And that might actually be all the lockboxes that I know of offhand right now. I'm not sure. I found so many that maybe there's more. Two flame rounds for the grenade launcher. You know what, guys? I think that's what we're going to take into Lucas's area. Because the burner is kind of sucking now with how strong the enemies have gotten. And I just don't have a ton of magnum ammo, so I think the grenade launcher is going to be the way to go. And if I want to use all of my strong chem fluid, I can actually make a shitload of flame rounds right now, I think. And that sounds awesome. Alright, guys. What we're gonna do now is actually watch the Happy Birthday tape. I don't know why I said that so weird. And, store that, store that. Take the grenade launcher and the flame rounds. We have three and whatever ammo came with the grenade launcher. And we're also gonna need the blue key card. Okay. Oh, this is gonna be awful and horrifying, but let's pop this sucker in and see what it is. Happy birthday! Experiment. Can trespassing idiots solve puzzles? Clancy Javis. Oh, this is one of the filmmaking dudes. Yeah, we never did find out what happened to all those guys. We know what happened to some of them.
You must have friends. You are one lucky summer bitch. You know, I actually envy you. What? You don't believe me? This short? Well, you can't fake this. It has taken me weeks to finish this, but it is finally ready. And it's all for you. Oh, come on now. Don't be like that. It's gonna be fun. Just you wait.
I don't want it. I don't want whatever's happening here. I don't want to wait. Okay. All right. Exactly what the hell is that? Is it an actual corpse or a dummy? I don't know, but we have a candle now, and there's a lot of nails and something else. The minute this thing starts moving, I'm gonna just soil my underoos, guys. My lucky underoos. Okay, we got balloons. Oh, a toilet! Is there something good? No, just a bunch of flies and something disgusting in a toilet. Birthday cake. Really not a fan of this darkness. What is all this? Okay, seems to be... That's just a rope. Can't I, like, burn that or something? I guess not. That seems like it'd be really easy to get out of. What is that? Is that a whoopee cushion? What? What? That's unsettling. That's like some Grim Reaper shit or some kind of, like, I don't know, hooded demon. And wait, in the... oh, there's a... This is spewing, I guess that's gas. Oh, I should probably not stand right next to that with a candle. What? What? Oh, God.
I'm calling the game. I'd really like to make it out of this room alive and not die a horrible, painful death. I know. It's a temp title. Take a candle, light it, and put it on the cape. And remember to smile. This party is for you.
Fuck you!
Ethan voices what we all are thinking, guys. Okay, so... Okay, so that's gonna spray water every time we walk by it. We need to get past it with a lighted candle. Happy fucking birthday. Got a light? No, not yet, I don't. Lucas said you need to put a lit candle on the cake. Alright. I don't know what Lucas's obsession with birthdays are, because... Ooh, a whining key. Okay, we got a whining key, but now this barrel's leaking something. It appears to be oil, I guess. That's great. Oh, some kind of passcode for this. Crabs, hooded figure, plant, I guess. I don't know what the hell that is. Sword. I don't know, it's all very nondescript. Alright. Yeah, so we read the thing earlier that Lucas was inviting Oliver over to his birthday party, and that's when he ended up killing him. And I'm pretty sure he did that when he was just a little kid. Hey, this wasn't on before. Okay, so it's a picture of a dude. It's like a birthday party in the picture, and there's a killer clown right there. Creepy-ass lady in the back. Oh, is this the family? Is that Granny and Jack and... I don't know who that lady is. Doesn't really look like Marguerite. Oh, and they had a dog, too. They had a dog, guys. Where's the zombie dog in this game? You know it's coming. Shit. But yeah, so... That was like... I guess you can't really assume that Oliver's birthday party was the first time Lucas killed somebody. But it was, damn, that is, it's just getting bigger, isn't it? Is that like a timer? Is this gonna screw me? Like, it gets to the cake and I can't finish this because, I don't know. But yeah, Lucas just seems to like birthday parties, and he seems to enjoy killing people during birthday parties. Okay, we can interact with the hand. It's missing a finger. Can we use the crank on, or the winding key on this? Ah, fuck! Ah, dude, what'd I do? Oh, that's weird. This is kinda cool, this is like an escape room, honestly. Okay. Flush the toilet? Gross. I don't want to reach in there. I'm not even going to watch this, guys.
Ah, oh, fucking disgusting. Ugh. Ugh. This is gross.
Ugh. Ugh. Okay, I lied. I watched it, but I gagged a little. We got a dirty telescope. Select the telescope from your inventory. Okay. Use item. Oh, we can't see because it's all dirty. I bet you we can fix that. We have water right over here. Ha, nailed it. But it doesn't actually let us see any further or anything. I don't like looking through this thing because it restricts my vision. If I turn around and there's somebody behind me... I don't know how I'm gonna handle it, guys. I just don't know. So... Oh! Oh, check this out. This is the passcode. What was that noise? It just played a noise like I found something. Is it just because I was looking at this? It's really weird. And also, I can't help but notice that in this whole monochrome type experience, the color on these stars stands out. I guess because it's a birthday. All right, so... It looks like a person, like, swinging from something, and then, I guess that's, like, the hooded figure, and then a fetus. A hooded figure with, like, something on his head. Alright, let's see if we can use that. Where was that thing? Right here? Let's see. Let us just see. Okay, that right there. Hooded figure with thing on top, and fetus. Got it! Oh god, what is this? A straw doll? You know, I haven't been doing a good job of, like, examining items I pick up in detail. I don't think it's really hurt me so far yet, but it's probably something I should be doing anyway. I have no idea what we're gonna do with this. Straw doll. Okay, the oil is, like, literally all over this room now. I don't know if that was a timer, or if that's, like, supposed to happen, but... If it's a timer, I failed miserably. Oh shit! The oven. I didn't see we could interact with this. Okay, we got fire! Can I burn the straw doll? I can. Is this like a... Oh, I just burned it away. Hey! We got a dummy finger. Okay, and we can also probably light the candle, I'm assuming? Okay, we can light the candle. But we haven't solved this water issue yet. So I'm not sure what that's going to do for us. Um, Okay, yep. Well, we got the dummy finger at least, so we can do whatever the fuck this is gonna do. Okay. We put the finger on, it still wants something else though. Looks like it could hold something. Oh shit. Right. So we haven't figured that out the whole way yet. What else is there? We have this lock on this door over here. Seriously, it's just a stupid... Oh, now we can interact with it. Okay. They wouldn't let me do this before, but I bet you now we can burn through it. That's slightly annoying, because I think I had already figured that out before, but the game just wouldn't let me do it out of sequence. That kind of stuff bothers me. Luckily, I didn't waste a lot of time getting tripped up on it, though. Yep, there we go. Nailed it. Oh, Jesus. Oh, man. Okay, they're popping. Fuck! Do I have to pop all of them? Are they hiding something? They are! Okay, we got a balloon. Just one single solitary balloon out of all the ones in here. Oh, we can probably blow it up with that thing that's shooting out of the wall. What's this? It would be difficult to open without the password. Well, let me try anyway. It's a five-digit thing. It's probably just his name, Lucas, because he's an idiot. Or a five-character word that describes Lucas, like moron, idiot, pansy, any of the above. All right, where was the damn thing blowing the... Here we go. There's spikies on it. Don't stand there! I could have prevented that if the game had left me in control. Wow, man, that really stabbed me. Quill pen. That was deep in there, too. That was some serious shit. Okay. Well, quill pen's probably what he wants to hold. Let's go ahead and light this again. Oh, I accidentally used the quill pen, but it doesn't let us burn that anyway. Can we burn the telescope? Just for funsies? Nope. Okay. I still don't trust this dude. I don't think I can use this candle as a weapon, but I don't think I have any choice but to do this. Alright, let's see what he writes. I bet he'll write the password. Oh, fuck!
What are you doing? Oh, man. No!
Ow! Oh, okay, he wrote it on me. Loser. It is a five-character word that describes Lucas. I was right, guys. Why is my arm not bleeding more, though? You'd be bleeding like a bitch if that actually happened to you. I'm actually really enjoying this sequence. This is fun. It is like an escape room, almost. I would bet you that was like there. Fappy. But yeah, I would assume that was kind of like their inspiration for this. Escape rooms have kind of become like a recent fad. Alright. I almost put in Lucas anyway. I kind of want to do that just to see if there's like something hidden, like an Easter egg or something. Can we actually make Lucas? Nope. Straight up doesn't work. That's disappointing. Oh well. I tried. Loser. It's weird how you have like some characters, but not all of them. By the way, guys, I just want to share this. When I first walked into this room, you know what I thought of? One of the first images I ever saw on the internet was a picture of some middle-aged corporate dude sitting in his office, and his office was filled with balloons, like up to the waist, just filled with balloons, and he was just sitting there with the most sour look on his face because somebody had pranked him and just filled his office with balloons, and it was fucking hilarious, but that was like so long ago. I don't even know if that image still exists on the internet. Here. Got a valve handle. Okay. I haven't actually noticed a place to use that yet. But we have it. There could also be an Easter egg for popping all of these. Seems like you gotta, like, pop them up and make them land on your candle. I'm not gonna actually do that, though, because it's probably a waste of time. So, is there like a line or something we can follow to turn the water off with the valve? There's a valve right up there. Oh no, that's a shower head, never mind. Oh, or it could be like right here in front of me. Did that do it? That did it! Alright, we can light the cake, guys. I'm sure everything will be fine once we do this. Happy, happy birthday, happy birthday. Happy fucking birthday. Okay. Wow, it just blew up. Of course it did. And now I'm on fire. That is not the sounds I would be making if I was on fire, guys. Shit, turn the water back on. Turn it back on. Of course. Of course. Okay.
Happy birthday!
Fuck you, Lucas. Fuck you so hard. My question is, how do we have that on tape? Because I obviously wasn't carrying a video camera. I guess he could have like put it on my shoulder or something, like a tiny micro camera? But wouldn't it have also burned up when I did? I don't know. Or it could have been a streaming feed recording to another location somewhere else. You know what? Technology's crazy, guys. You could do shit like that. I guess that's not really that big a deal. Also, that wasn't quite as scary as it could have been because it was so telegraphed. Like, I knew something was going to happen with that oil when I went back in there with the flame, so it was kind of like... Like, it was disturbing to watch, but it didn't really creep me out as much as, like, some of the stuff with Jack or Marguerite. Also, this load screen takes fucking forever. Okay, we're finally back. That takes like literally a full minute, maybe even a little more, to get out of that load screen. Well, that's another tape in the bucket. I actually don't know what that did for me. The tapes don't actually seem to do anything for you. They just like... They just add to the horror. They might give you a glimpse of an area that's coming up. In the case of like the Marguerite video, but I don't know if that one will really help us out at all. In any case, okay, so... let's move that down there. We don't have a ton of handgun ammo, but we are rocking 10 shotgun shells. And I'm gonna bring, like, a whole stack of herbs to heal myself with. Because I only have one real... first aid med. And I've got a bunch of strong chem fluid. I can't figure out if I want to use those on flame rounds or... better first aid meds. I don't know. I'm probably just gonna leave them as is for now. But I think at this point we've accomplished everything we wanted to, guys. When we come back, we will head for the Lucas area and see what horror awaits us there. Thanks, guys. I appreciate it. I'll catch you then. Bye.